Hello everybody, my name is Ossi Mäntylahti and in this video we're going to go through the resupply operations in Odoo using multiple warehouses. Let me share my screen and let's get started. So we will first go through a little bit of theory and then we will be going to see how this is done in the real system. So. Okay, now the windows are okay. So first, in our example case, we will be having two warehouses. We will be having a Helsinki warehouse and we will be having City Pizza warehouse. In this case, the purchases are done typically so that they are arriving to Helsinki warehouse and then Helsinki warehouse resupplies the City Pizza warehouse. In both warehouses, there is a point of sale so that the end customers are buying from this warehouse. And also when we are doing the normal sales operations using Odoo sales module, we can be using both warehouses as source. However, we are also having one e-commerce website, and in Odoo's case, the Odoo's e-commerce website for one company can only be connected to one site. So we are buying to Helsinki and then we are selling from City Pizza. So how do we do this in Odoo? First, we need to set up something in Odoo's configuration. We need to set up multi-step routes that allows this. And what it does, then second thing what we need to do is that we need to go to the warehouse that will be resupplied. And we need to be selecting that this warehouse is being resupplied from the other warehouse. For this warehouse, we should also be clearing the setting of buy to resupply so that we are not buying, so that Odoo will not create the purchases or purchase orders for this warehouse. Once you have set these things up, you will be seeing this routes button. And in this routes button, we can go and see that the City Pizza warehouse is having the following routes. That this City Pizza warehouse, WH, is getting its products from Helsinki warehouse. And last thing that what we need to do is that we need to go to the product. And we need to set up that in the inventory tab, we need to set up that this product is getting its routes from City Pizza warehouse, which is supplying from Helsinki warehouse and buy because we are also buying this product. But it is coming to Helsinki warehouse. Sounds complicated. And therefore, it is a good idea to check which routes are active for this product. So, and Odoo has this icon with routes with three little gears. And if you go there, you can actually get a routes report. And typically, if you select all the warehouses there, you will be seeing that Odoo generates you reports on how the flow of the product goes. So just put all the warehouses there, don't put anything in the specific routes, and Odoo will generate this kind of diagram for you. And this is actually quite informative. We will be seeing that when we have vendors, we are seeing this pink line, and recipients are coming from our vendors and they are arriving to Helsinki stock. Then we have two routes where we are going to be, where we can sell products using Odoo's sales application or the point of sales. We can sell them from VH stock and we can sell them also from Helsinki stocks. and they are going to be going to go to the customers. And the last but not least is that we are sending from Helsinki these yellow lines from Helsinki to transit location, and then from transit location we are sending to VH stock. So the last yellow lines are illustrating how the resupply operations work from these two between these two warehouses. Word of caution: once you set up something like this, you are essentially introducing bureaucracy. And typically, when we have seen in our clients who are starting to use Odoo and their warehouse operations, they have the wish that they would like to implement every single little control there. That's not always such a good idea, because that means that you are essentially introducing a lot of bureaucracy, and you have to complete these every single time when the product moves are done. So that's okay if you really want to do it, but just be aware that every single rule that you will be putting requires you also to be completing these operations. You cannot skip the operations anymore. You need to go in and you need to validate these. Couple of rules, words about the pull rules and push rules. You may have seen these in the dialogue already, but the arrows, how they are drawn, are actually significant. A pull rule essentially means that this rule will be triggering when there's a need for this kind of product. For example, when a customer makes an order, Odoo automatically generates a pull and applies the pull rule. Push rules are a bit easier to understand because you are essentially triggering these rules as soon as a product arrives to a certain location. Typical example of these ones are that products are arriving to your loading area, and then you want to store them certain locations in your inventory. You can also implement these rules so that you might want to check, for example, quality of the products. If something is broken, you can return them and so on. Be aware that the rule configuration can be something that it's very easy to make mistakes there. So recommendation: plan this in advance and test these rules step by step before implementing these in the production environment. We have seen cases when these rules are quite difficult to do, and debugging them is often quite serious pain, quite seriously painful. So, for example, here we have a real case when we are seeing that there is one customer who is very confused why is their product showing that there is availability in the stock, even that the available quantity is shown as zeros. The reason for that one is that we can see that there is a virtual quantity, which is also called forecast quantity in Odoo. And in order to see this, there's an excellent extension by Webcool. It's called stocks per warehouse, and that it doesn't change anything in Odoo's functionality, but it will show this new tab in the product variants where these warehouse stocks will be visible. Highly recommended if you haven't gotten it. It's $30 and a very, very good investment. So I mentioned that the debugging can be quite painful, and for example, in this example, we are seeing that there is one internal transfer that is not completed yet. So, for example, sales and purchases are easy to understand. You need to complete them. You need to validate them. But in the case when you are doing internal transfers, or which is more difficult, if Odoo is generating automatically internal transfers to you, then you need to understand that if you have set the feeding routes between the warehouses, you need to go and validate that this has actually taken place. The problem is that that if you are not careful there, this means that we are easily getting something is getting stuck. So that's pretty much the theory, and we can now take a look at how this works in the production environment, in the real client environment. This is a demo site that I have created for these purposes, and we can see that we have this product, salsa ketchup 500 milliliters. And let's see how I have configured this product so that we will go and see it in the inventory. Let's go to inventory, master data, products. And my ketchup is here. So we can see that we have currently 0 units in hand. And if you go to see the warehouse stocks quantity, which I was already advising that this is very good extension, we can see that there is 0, 0, 0 everywhere. So let's go and see that what we are seeing on the reordering rules. And in our case, I have selected that there are now 2 reordering rules. So we have put the City Pizza warehouse that it has minimum 0 units and maximum 5 units. And in the Helsinki warehouse, there is 3 units and maximum 10 units. So now let's see the routes still. And the routes are here. We are seeing that the inventory tab is showing that the route is by for Helsinki warehouse. And from Helsinki warehouse, we are supplying from Helsinki to City Pizza warehouse. So now to trigger the rules, we can do the operations and run the scheduler. And here Odoo will be running the scheduler, and let's see what happens now. Now, if we refresh this one, we can see that we are that Helsinki warehouse is supplying 5 units to City Pizza warehouse because this is the rule. But we don't have anything coming to Helsinki warehouse. So let's go and see our purchase module. And here we can see that we have now created the RFQ for the products. And we can see that Odoo wants to buy 10 units of ketchup, salsa ketchup here. So that's fine. We want to do it. So let's confirm this order. And before going to receive the products, let's see what happens in the forecast. So we can now go to forecast, refresh this, stocks per warehouse, and now what we are seeing. Now we are seeing that we have 10 units incoming and there is 5 units outgoing. That's because Helsinki warehouse is supplying to City Pizza warehouse. And this is also visible that if we refresh this product here, and now we check availability in the store, we can see 5 and 5. This is because this extension is showing the virtual quantity of this product, like expected quantity in each warehouse. So let's go and complete the order, let's make a sale of this product. So let's make a sale. Mr. Mexico user. And we select 4 units from City Pizza warehouse. Save. And now we can see that there is a red eye. Why is there red? It means that we don't have it yet. We can see 0 units and 0 units. So let's see the forecast. Yep, we can see that there is now forecasted 5, but we don't have those yet. So if we try to fulfill this order, we confirm this. And now we can see that the line is blue. Why is this line blue? Let's see our warehouse stocks availability right now. Now we can see that there's outgoing quantity 4 from the City Pizza warehouse. As I did the sale, but we cannot qualify this yet. So the next thing, what we need to do, we need to complete the purchase order. But hold on, before going to the purchase order, let's go and see the inventory and operations and transfers. And there's a bunch of transfers here. So let me actually show you that I have now applied to filter. I want to see draft, waiting, ready, and cancelled, so that these are all the orders that are there in the system, and they are all except the done. And we can see that there is something coming, but now we need to receive these products. So let's go and receive the products. Here we go, reception. And we are seeing that 10 units are coming. Let's validate this. So now we are receiving the 10 units of this product. So now let's go to see the virtual stocks. And the virtual stocks are looking pretty good. Now we can see that we have 10 units in hand in Helsinki warehouse. We just received them, but the virtual quantity is 5. Why is the virtual quantity 5? That is because we have already 5 going from Helsinki to City Pizza. Now we need to complete this operation as well. So let's go to see the inventory and transfers. And let's see. And here we now are seeing that there is going to be 2 operations that we have not yet completed. Which one is the first one? Operation. Let's check that. Can we do this? Yes, we can. This is coming nicely. Validate this. Yes, I want to do all of these 10. Sorry, 5. Let's see again what happened here. And now we can see that the outgoing quantity is 0. City Pizza warehouse is now having the incoming quantity of 5, but they are not yet available. We need to complete this one from that end as well. And it's here in the transfers. And where is it? Is it this one? Yes. Yep, same salsa. No, this is not yet it, because now this is, that's the sales order that I did. We need to receive the products in here, and let's see transfers, and let me go to filter, transfers not yet done, and it's WHO stock, waiting operations. Well, this is not yet it. It's transit location. Yes, this is the one. Transit location is 5, and we have not yet done any. So now we can validate this. So the point taken here. Yep. So now we received this product, and let's see here what happens how it is reflected. Now we can see that now the quantity in City Pizza is 5, because now we have gotten the 5 units there. The point to take home here is that every time that we do an internal transfer, and it is not an automatic transfer, there needs to be 2 validations, one for the send and one for the reception. So let's finish this. And here we go. Yep. This is now validated, but there is still one transfer to be done, and it is our transfer to the customer. So this is for Mexico user, who was our client, 4 units of this one. So let's check the availability now. Now we have reserved 4. Let's see what happens here. Let's refresh this. Yep, no change. It is outgoing 4, and now we can validate this. And now we have sent this to the customer. So, and now if we go here, we can see that the warehouse tax is now showing that in Helsinki warehouse we have 5 units. And in City Pizza warehouse, we have one unit available, and virtual quantity is also 1, so there is no difference. So just before we finish, let's do something funny here, and let's run the scheduler another time. And before doing it, I'll let you think for a minute what will happen if I run the scheduler, because remember, this is what we have set for the rules. So let's run the scheduler. And we can see the warehouse stocks. So do you think that there's any change? No, there is no change. And this is because the reordering rules are saying that the City Pizza warehouse can have 0 units, between 0 and 3, and the Helsinki warehouse can have between 5 and 10 of these. So there is no need for to be transferring any more of these at this point. So essentially, that is the live demonstration on how the reordering rules between multiple warehouses work. I hope that this video has been useful for you to understand the concepts and to see this in live action. Thank you all, and have a nice day.